Well, crews are again working around the clock to make sure your roads are clear.
And with the 3 snowstorms this season, we wanted to know if that's breaking the budget. KMBC 9's Martin Augustine is live with the answers. Martin?
Well, and even for the hardiest of you out there, all of this shoveling of the snow and ice of the last month, well, it's kind of worn out its welcome, even for some of you who do this for a living.
After what seemed like a month of nonstop work, we asked if KDOT's plow drivers who cleared off this latest storm so efficiently are ready for a break.
It gets a little frustrating.
They are. Rick Looper's a day late now for a long-awaited vacation delayed by the weekend storm. He and other weary plow drivers sure would like it if this turns out to be the last time they crawl into the camper this season. But they know the job too well.
We're hoping, but with Mother Nature, you never know. You know, we're always getting everything prepared, everything cleaned up, and ready for the next one.
And if there is a next one, how are we set to pay for all the cleanup?
This is one of the salt storage domes of Kansas City, Missouri, and the city still is in very good shape when it comes to material to put down on streets and highways. Prior to the February storms, the city had 25,000 tons of material to use. And prior to this latest storm, it still had 17,000 tons.
Keep in mind, after last winter's lack of snow, Kansas City had plenty of unused material for this winter. A public works spokesman saying that savings amounts to $1.5 million. So despite the late winter and early spring snowstorms, Kansas City's snow removal budget is sound. For this winter, the city budgeted $2.8 million for snow removal. Prior to the weekend storm, it still had $1 million of that budget remaining.
By comparison, across the state line in Overland Park, the city there typically plans on spending in the neighborhood of $1 million on snow removal. Before this latest storm, it still had $600,000 in that budget. Reporting live, Martin Augustine, KMBC 9 News.
All right, thank you, Martin. And like Kansas City, an Overland Park spokesman says, the city has plenty of salt in its salt domes.